Okay, we're here today in Carrigaline, December the 15th, and we're lobbying against salmon farms. And we're going to be marching as far as Simon Coveney's office, and we're going to send them a very clear message today that this is unacceptable and we do not accept salmon farms.
Horrendous plan that has been cooked up by the government to give Ireland a massive tonnage of artificial farmed salmon would destroy the entire coastline of Ireland. It would actually destroy tourism. It is one of the most potentially dangerous time bombs against the environment that has ever been foisted upon Ireland.
But how many jobs will be lost when our native salmon and sea trout become extinct because of these farms? Angling knows no divides. It brings people and communities together. It builds bridges and creates jobs on our rivers, in our valleys, and on our lakes. As a game angling instructor, I have a wonderful job. It has been my privilege to take people fishing who are disabled, people who have problems with depression, people who have addictions, people who are out of work and trying to return to work, mother and daughter groups, fathers and sons, cancer victims, stag and hen parties and corporate groups. You see, fishing can and should be part of our daily lives and should be available to everyone.
If the government has any respect for wild salmon returning to rivers in Ireland, they will not allow these licenses to be granted. The main argument by government bodies is the creation of jobs. Yes, we agree, but not at the cost of so many others. Can you imagine what would happen to jobs if wild salmon returning were endangered? It would have catastrophic consequences for the tourism industry, an industry this government drastically is trying to promote and grow. We have met all our West Cork public representatives, TDs and county councillors in relation to the application for the extension of salmon farming in Bantry Bay. While they were quite helpful, they pleaded that A, they were not up to speed on environmental pollution issues, and B, issues of salmon license applications is being held in the department in Dublin, so that the matter is out of their hands. We accepted none of these arguments. First of all, as public representatives, people we elect, they have a responsibility to inform themselves on issues that affect the local communities. And secondly, all issues and important issues that affect the whole country. They say that this issue is complicated, so we presented them with full information on the subject. We stated at their public representatives and that this issue is of great concern to the public and cannot be ignored by anybody in a position of influence.
The Norwegian government gave the Nobel Peace Prize to Liu Xiaobo, the famous Chinese civil rights activist. Now, the Chinese government responded by refusing to buy any more Norwegian salmon. So our Minister for the Marine, Mr. Colney, hopped over to Shanghai and agreed to supply the Chinese with as much salmon as they wanted. Now, this will require the construction of huge industrialized-sized farms. So Bord Ísgeðvarar's complex earmarked for Galway Bay will be twice the size of Inishgear itself. And the minister intends to build many more similar complexes along the west coast, for which you, the taxpayer, will cough up 70 million euros for structure. And these fish will be organic fish. Now, just think about it. These fish will be doused with insecticides, they'll be fed colorants to keep their flesh pink, they'll be dosed with antibiotics, their food will be laced with anti-lice chemicals and animal bone meal, and they'll be vaccinated and crossbred for maximum growth. They will be four times fatter than any wild salmon. And in my book, foisting such fish on the public as organic is a sham. The only agency describing salmon reared in such conditions as organic are Bord Ísgeðvarar. The term organic has become a cheater's charter because it has simply no legal standing. Now, to begin with the building of his mega farms, Mr. Coveney has bizarrely asked Bord Ísgeðvarar to apply to himself for a license to build these farms. You couldn't really make this stuff up, ladies and gentlemen, because as soon as the license is granted, Bord Ísgeðvarar will hand over the complex to someone else to run. And you can bet your next wage packet that it will be the Norwegian John Fredriksen, owner of Marine Harvest, who controls the majority of salmon production in Ireland. But let's spare a thought for poor old Mr. Fredriksen. He needs the money, because he's only worth 11.7 billion pounds. And where will the huge profits go? Will they go to build new hospitals or schools or playing fields for the kids? No. Much of the rental from these complexes will be divvied out amongst the big boys of Bord Ísgeðvarar and into their pension funds. Mr. Fredriksen will shovel his extra millions into the Norwegian banks, and Mr. Coveney will win the political brownie points he so eagerly seeks. The big losers will, of course, be you, the public, and your children, and the poor old Irish environment. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this to me smacks of the good old Celtic tiger again. These huge untried complexes are based on the same Alice in Wonderland planning, the same selfish greed, and the same refusal to listen to common sense. Well, common sense is what we've brought here today. And we're here to tell the Minister of the Marine that we do not believe the garbage handed out to us by Bord Ísgeðvarar. And neither do we accept the trash trotted out to us by the minister himself. We here today, and I think I speak for you all, we refuse to listen to any more lies. We refuse to have our fish destroyed and our country and waterways polluted and degraded. Mr. Coveney, no mega salmon farms.